Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. If you watched my last video, it is not my last video. That was an April Fool's joke. I'm sorry if I fooled you, but there are lots of tutorials on the way. And today I'm excited to share with you an advanced green screen tutorial specifically helping you how to maintain the hair details when you're keying, because that's the thing that always gets you. The hair is the hardest part, because oftentimes when you're keying and you're trying to get rid of all the green in the hair, you kind of create a really bad haircut on the person and it just doesn't look natural. But the way that you can do it is by using a specific Keylight tool in After Effects with a couple other presets, and it will help maintain the detail. So I'm going to show you how to use this preset. And the reason why I'm using After Effects and not Premiere Pro is that the After Effects Keylight tool is far superior to the Ultra Key effect, which is what you use in Premiere Pro to remove the green screen. So leaving this tutorial, become a pro at knowing exactly what to do, so that way you're not just using the dropper tool and then just kind of guessing on what the parameters do. So I've linked to all of the different steps as time codes down below, so you can skip around and review to make sure that you understand how everything works. And also the demo clip, you can download it to follow along just down below in the description box. And this demo clip was provided by Videvo. And thank you so much to Videvo for supporting today's video. They have hundreds of thousands of free clips that you can download from stock video, motion graphics, music, sound effects. And what's really great about Videvo is that it actually tells you the licensing, and it's really easy. So you can pretty much use any clip in any type of video project, whether it's personal, commercial, for a client, for your YouTube channel, it doesn't matter. And if you're specifically looking for green screen clips, it has a ton of great green screen clips that you can use with tablets and monitors if you want to use that in your commercial. And if you want to get a premium plan where you can access the more premium clips, not the free clips, you can use my code GAL15 to get 15% off. All right, thank you so much, Videvo. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the green screen. So the first step is creating a mask around your subject. The reason why I'm creating a mask around this subject is you want to isolate just the part of the green screen that the person is in. I did this in the hologram tutorial because you can see a bunch of different stuff in my studio, and all you need to do is isolate the part around your subject, because there's shadows on the edges and it will help you make a more refined key if you isolate and you subtract as much green screen as possible. If you're dealing with a more complex shot, because in this clip the person is not moving that much, he's pretty much just standing still and adjusting his tie for this clip, you may want to use another software called Mocha by Boris Effects, which is built into After Effects. There's also a Mocha Pro, and I made a tutorial on how to use that, which you can click and watch up here. So to create the mask, you're going to go to the pen tool and you're going to click around your subject, and if you want to make a curved line, you're just going to click and hold and it will make a curved line and you can adjust it. So go all the way around and close it off, and now we have our mask. And now it's time for the keying. So go to effects and search for Keylight. You can apply the Keylight effect by itself, but instead I'm going to recommend choosing the preset, which also includes the key cleaner and the advanced spill suppression. So drag and drop this onto the video clip, and now from effect controls you can see that we have all three effects applied. For now, just turn off the key cleaner and make sure that the advanced spill suppression is off, and we're just going to focus on the Keylight effect first. So first, use the dropper tool to select the key color and try to select a medium green color, one that's not too dark or not too bright, and choose it closer to the hair of our subject. Now it did a pretty good job, but as we zoom in and use the H key on our keyboard, the hand tool to move around, you can see we need to make some refinement around the edges of our subject. Before we do the refinement, go up to View and change it to Screen Matte. And you can see how the mat is doing. So here you can see some work needs to be done because there's lots of gray areas. And the gray just simply means that there's some slight transparency, okay? So you don't want any gray in the white areas of the foreground. You want the foreground to be completely white, which is opaque. In the background, you don't want any gray areas either. You just want it to be pure black, which is pure transparent, okay? So that's what the colors mean. To remove the gray areas, we need to adjust the screen matte controls. First, we will clip the black. So let's open up the clip black controls, and you can use the slider, and we can start to move it over to the right to clip the black until we see the gray areas start to go away. But if you move it too much, you can see that it starts to clip into the hair too much, and we don't want it to trim the hair too much. So try to do as least amount of clipping of the black as possible. So for this shot, between 10 and 15 is good for now, but every clip is different. But you don't want it to be too much, because then you're going to trim the hair. All right, so next for the clip white. We will roll the slider this time to the left, and as we roll it, you'll see a bit more detail come into the hair. And as we roll it back, you might also need to clip the black more, because as we roll the white to the left, it starts to bring in more gray in the background. So now let's zoom out and move down to make sure everything else is looking good in the shot into the body. And if all is good, then we can close the screen matte tools and we can change the view back to intermediary result. And I'll explain why we're using intermediary result and not the final result in just a moment. But for right now, we're going to zoom into the edge of the hair. And here you can see there's still a lot of green and it's kind of jagged and ugly. So this is where the key cleaner comes in handy. So watch what happens when we turn on the key cleaner. Immediately, you can see it gets more soft around the hair, so it's not so much of a harsh edge. And now when we play it back, though, you can see that there's this awful chattering happen. It's like kind of like if something is kind of flaky and animating around the hair. And that just means that it's confused. Keylight is confused because the hair is so soft, it's not sure what is transparent and what's not. But what's really cool about the key cleaner is you can turn off the chattering by checking the box, reduce chatter box. And now when we play it back, you can see almost all of that chattering is gone. So you don't even really have to do much. It's just checking the box, which is great. So if you don't want as soft as an edge around the edges of the hair, you can reduce the edge radius. And I'd recommend around 7 or 8. If you lower it too much, you can see that the edges start to get a little bit too jagged as well. Also, be sure to look at the rest of your subject as well, so you can use the hand tool to go around and see how the edges of the jacket are doing. You don't want the jacket to also have soft edges, because the key cleaner also affects all edges of the body. So this is why I recommended to lower the edge radius, so that way the edges of his shoulders are not too soft as well. But you can see we still have the green in his hair. This is where we're going to use the advanced spill suppression. And this is really magical. So what you're going to do is literally just turn on the advanced spill suppressor and that's it. The green just disappears automatically. It's pretty amazing. So all that this did is neutralize the green screen. So if we turn off the key light effect, you can see that it turned the background into kind of a navy blue, darker gray black kind of background. So the green screen was just neutralized, and that's how it got rid of the green spill in the hair. So this is a key part of helping you refine your hair key, is using the advanced spill suppression. If you want to crop more of the hair or add more of the hair, this is where you can go back into the clip white parameters from the screen matte. So if you increase the slider to the right, you'll see that more hair will be cropped out. And if you lower it, more hair will come in. But remember that the more hair that comes in, the more opportunity for a little bit more chattering to happen. So you just have to be careful with that slider and preview it to make sure everything looks okay. So you might ask, why did we use the intermediary result and not the final result? Well, actually, as part of this preset, when you first apply the Keylight preset that includes the key cleaner and the suppression, it auto defaults to intermediary. And that's because the intermediary actually works better when you're dealing with hair keying. And more often than not, you're going to use this preset. If we switch it to the final result, you can see that the edges are just kind of jagged and it doesn't look that great. And the reason why it doesn't look great is because final result assumes that you're going to be using all of the other complex parameters, and you're going to be playing around with the inside mask, the outside mask, the foreground color, the background color. And there's so many parameters inside of the Keylight that final result works better with those. But in most cases, just using the preset with intermediary works better than having to play around with all the controls, which we don't even need to go into, which is great. So that's why we use the intermediary result and not the final result. So what I just showed you how to do was remove the key, right? And everything is looking great. But now compositing and putting a background behind your subject is a whole nother thing. So this is what I'm kind of categorizing as the compositing section of this tutorial. So what you're going to do is drag your background clip below the layer of your green screen, and you can see the background is there, and you can start to position it so it looks natural behind your subject, the right height, etc. It could be a video, it could just be a photo, a still behind your subject. In our case, it's just a still of like an office space. So the first thing I want to do is color matching to make it look like the subject and the background have the same lighting. So you're going to go up to Effects and you're going to search for Color Matcher and drag Color Matcher onto the background layer. And then from Effects Controls, you can change the target layer to be the foreground video of the person that you keyed. And immediately you can see a difference. You can also increase or decrease the strength of the effect, or you can blend it with the original until it looks good. Now let me show you another tool, Light Wrap. So go to Effects and you're going to search for Light Wrap and drag it onto our foreground layer, which is our top layer. Now from Effect Controls, you're going to choose the background layer as the Light Wrap, which is the office background in my case. So it may look like at first that it's cutting away from the hair and the edge, but all it's actually doing is wrapping an edge of light in the same color as the background around our subject. And if you increase the width of this edge, you can see what it's doing more accurately. But in our case, we don't want it to be so intense. So typically I'll change the width to around 25, and then I'll choose over because it creates a more natural blend. And then I'm going to increase the background blur, and I will also blend it heavily with the original. And now if I turn it on and off, you can just see a really subtle touch of lighting around the edge. I don't want too much in this case. Of course, with whatever shot you're working with, it might be a little bit different. So you may have to play around with this width until it looks good for your scene. And now as a final touch to the composite, I like to create an adjustment layer. So right click on the empty space here and add a new adjustment layer. Then from Effects, search for Lumetri Color and drag Lumetri Color onto the adjustment layer. And underneath the creative section of Lumetri, you can try out a bunch of these creative looks that come built in and see how it affects the overall image. And you can reduce the intensity of it so it looks more natural. So all this did was apply this color look to the entire composition, both the foreground and the background, giving it more similarity. Of course, you don't have to use this effect. It's just something I like to do. I just wanted to show it to you in case you might want to apply an adjustment layer for your footage, but maybe your background and the foreground already look really similar and you may not even need to use a LUT or a color look from Lumetri Color. And lastly, we're going to add a camera lens blur to the background. So just go to Effects, search for camera lens blur, and apply it to the background. And now it has more of a natural camera lens blur, so it's more blurry compared to the foreground. And so following these steps, you should know how to key subjects out really professionally going forward. And I would say more often than not, you're going to use that Keylight, Key Cleaner, and Spill Suppression preset, which comes built in inside of After Effects. It's a huge, huge time saver. If it helps you out, you know, be sure to give it a big thumbs up because it helps me know if the tips that I'm giving you are applicable. And also be sure to leave any comments below if you have any questions. And lastly, thank you again to Videvo for supporting today's video and helping make this tutorial by providing the clips. Don't forget, you can get 15% off using my code GAL15 to access any of their premium clips. That's it for today's video. And per usual, keep creating better video with GAL.